10-year-note Treasury yields had a huge day. They had a massive week, and if you want to even take it back further, they've had a huge turnaround month. Obviously, the fears and the panic that have been kind of instilled into this coronavirus in the expectations of what it could bring economically, not necessarily the reality yet. We are seeing a black swan event that has not been seen, I think even bigger than what we saw in 2008, 2009 in the financial crisis, the effect of the markets, given the fact that 10-year note Treasury yields traded down to 65 basis points. Now that's about 100 basis points less than the Treasury issued 10 years last month. And doesn't look like we're going to see any major upswing in the short term. Certainly, it would be nice to get back above 1%. It's kind of funny to hear you say that out loud. 1% 10-year note yields seem cheap. But at this point, the market is still kind of recalculating itself, getting its bearings. And I think that the range we saw today from about 65 basis points to 95 basis points tells the story in that we are going to see massive wide ranges. We are going to continue to see lower lows and possibly, retracements back higher. It's just going to be those kind of days. Market volatility, well, we're at multi-year highs. And at this point, it's kind of tough to say, oh, yeah, we're going to come off next week. No, because a lot of this uncertainty is being priced into the data expectations for not only this quarter, but next quarter and even throughout the year, growth numbers. How will this slowdown in the global growth slowdown based on what we know about the coronavirus, how is that going to affect everyday people? How is it going to affect the numbers? We're already seeing it in travel. And I think at this point, you're going to see it in a lot of other areas in the short term. And that's why the market's got this huge uncertainty cloud over it. And you see this mad dash out of equities and risk assets. And where are they going? Well, they're coming right into the bond market. So volatility off the charts. It will come down, but it didn't come down and ended on the highs as we go home for the weekend. And lastly, everybody's watching the equity markets. They are pretty much, they're pretty much the art here that everyone's looking at. But the bond market's telling you the real story, and that is that yields are going down. And if you look at our friends across the pond in Europe, their yields all went down years ago and never really rebounded. The UK is the only one. They went south of 1.25 last year. The French and the Germans did it years ago. And I think at this point, that's a clear message is that when a central bank stays involved and keeps rates at zero, you're gonna see all your issues follow. That's exactly what's happened over there. And now we're starting to see it here. Now we were able to get off the zero bound with a few rate hikes a few years ago, but then again we had to take it back a little bit. And now we're finding out that the Fed's going to be not only taking back the 50 basis points that it cut this week. Probably another 50 in the next couple of weeks at the March FOMC and maybe again at the April FOMC, depending on if we get any clarity on the growth and on the economic numbers and on what's going on in the market. So at this point, all bets are off as to any normalcy, at least for the next few weeks. And I think at this point, Treasury notes are going to continue to nudge lower, if not gap lower, if there's any kind of headline that's going to force things. And at this point, 50 basis points doesn't seem that all that far away. And that's a level that I don't think anyone seriously took a few months ago, even if there was a black swan event, and we are amidst it now. So look for Treasury buyers to stand by looking to buy dips here. There is still a need to own them, and there is a scarcity of them out there, obviously, with everyone trying to bid them. Treasury yields should continue to go lower next week, but it will all start with the equity markets, and we'll finish in the bond market, and you'll see what happens when we open Sunday night. That will be a very key to see if equities can bounce back. They did have a little bit of a bounce back on Friday afternoon, still down in the day, but if they can get any positive momentum in the equity markets, it might stop the decline of yields in the Treasury market.